Chris Lewis, CHRISLOUIS, and I give Student Health 101 and UMass Boston permission to use this video.
Thank you very much. Chris, can you describe your caffeine consumption while stressed?
For me personally, I don't do a lot of caffeine. I don't drink much, but when it comes down to it, it's not that much because I tend to, I guess what you can say is that I tend to like overreact when it comes to, you know, trying to overcome stress when it comes to caffeine. The consumption of it kind of calms me down, but at the same time it energizes me to kind of overcome what I need to get done.
Okay. And think in terms of finals when I ask the next question, but describe your food consumption while stressed.
Food consumption, I would say it's a lot, not gonna lie, just for the simple fact that I feel like everybody loves food. Food actually kind of gives me that energy where, in terms, if I'm very not focused in what I have to do, then the food that I do consume helps me to actually come out of that non-focus and pretty much stay intact in what I need to get done.
Okay, and is there any specific type of foods or just whatever is handy at the time?
I believe just whatever is handy at the time. Normally I tend to not to stay away from like high fatty foods, high cholesterol foods, but normally it's just whatever is handy at the time, just so that I can have something to keep me going throughout the day.
Okay, now compare your eating habits while stressed and when bored or while bored.
I feel like there's a difference when I'm stressed and when I'm bored. I feel like I eat less when I'm bored and more when I'm stressed. Just for the simple fact that when there's nothing to do, I don't really feel like there's so much I can eat. But however, like being under the pressure, being under stress, I feel like I need that increase of food consumption when it comes to dealing with it rather than just being bored.
All right. Well, thank you very much. It was very informative. I hope this was not too bad.
Thank you so much.